Health News tonight, a major breakthrough for a common injury developed by a UConn bioengineer.
It's estimated a 500,000 people will tear their ACL this year. News 8 medical reporter Jocelyn Menta found out about an innovative way that could soon be used to treat patients.
Sorry, Sonia and Darren, the ACL is the main ligament that stabilizes the knee. The road to recovery from a torn ACL can be difficult. Through tissue engineering, there could be a better alternative.
Heidi Golden tore the ACL in her right knee.
And hyperextended my knee and it just, I heard a snap and that was it.
4 months after reconstructive surgery.
We had a cadaver ACL. I chose to do that over the other methods that are available. And basically he strung a new tendon between my, lower leg bone and upper leg bone.
Heidi is on the tough road to recovery, which can take up to a year for most patients.
We use this three-dimensional hierarchical structure. That's how we designed it.
Another choice developed by bioengineer Dr. Cato Lorenzen at UConn Health Center could cut down on rehab time. For the first time, a complete regeneration of ACL through tissue engineering. It begins with a matrix.
It's a synthetic polymer
that allows cells to attach and grow.
Once it's implanted in the body, we count on the body's own healing capacity to start to work too. And so the cells that actually regenerate the ACL actually come from the joint itself.
So far, positive outcomes from animal models.
Nicely regenerated.
Benefits for humans are promising.
We're sometimes protective of the knee because of the fact the mechanical properties aren't strong yet for the ACL. But now we'll have the ability to be able to rehab the knee even faster, get the knee moving even faster.
Early next year, human trials will begin in Europe.
Dr. Lorenzen tells me there's more to the regenerative tissue process. It can be applied to repairing other soft tissues, such as the rotator cuff. He's looking to begin human clinical trials on that soon here in the U.S. For more information on this study and other studies at UConn, log on to our website, WTNH.com.